Yes, you have to understand that Poland is the strange country, that we have anti-Semitism without Jews, we have hate to the Islam without Islamic people, we
Yeah.
have the hate to communism, but without without communists. I agree with you that that Communist Party of Poland is small and weak. And it is why we are constructing, building our party, the Polish Workers' Party, but it is other story. So I want to ask you about the situation which is now in Russia, about the demonstration to support the Navalny. So what do you think about Navalny, and what do you think about this protest? I read one article in the Trotskyist site internet, which they said that they don't support Navalny because he is liberal and stuff like this. But the people who protest, this is mass movement, and in the in and now in the last times, the politic of the Putin and all this government of Russia, it's the they support oligarchy. They wanted to make the age of the pensions bigger. They now in the time of the crisis, they cut the budget of the hospitals, and in the same time they make bigger the budget of the police. And people who demonstrate, they are not for liberal Navalny, but they are don't want this this oligarchic system which is in Russia. So I don't know what is the situation on Russia, and I don't have confidence with every colored revolution. When I heard colored revolution, I say I think that if CIA supports something, I am against, but I want to know what is your position.
Well, first, I'll just start with this is this example that you gave of the Trotskyist position is the typical Trotskyist position of being a useful idiot. You know, like it. I mean, these protests. Whoever goes to these protests, they're serving the political agenda of Alexei Navalny, who is a liberal capitalist, described himself as a market fundamentalist when asked about his political views. Doesn't matter who's going to these protests, they're serving his political agenda. Now, what they're saying about people being in the protests who have legitimate grievances with the economic conditions of Russia right now, or the po or political conditions, or with this or that law, or aren't satisfied with the quality of life they're living in. There's tons of people in the protests who are there because of that, who have never heard of maybe Alexei Navalny before, or maybe they have, but they don't even know what he stands for, but they are in these protests because of this. Now, this doesn't mean that we should support the protests, because this Alexei Navalny is using this for his own political agenda, which in the end, if is successful, will be a return to the 1990s. It's going to be, I mean, his policies are completely pro-Western liberal market fundamentalism in the United States, in Russia, sorry. And you know, he would let in people like Bill Browder, who can't go to Russia right now because they're facing charges of tax fraud from stealing from the people in the 1990s. You know, those people would have their they would be let back to keep doing what they were doing in the 1990s, making tons of money while other people were suffering, you know. And you know, I could say in short a little bit about Alexei Navalny, but of course, if people watching this video want to get a huge big picture, they could watch my 1 hour live about it. But basically, he is some sort of ultra nationalist who at the same time was got training alongside other people who participated in color revolutions at Yale University in 2010.